Regan Kateraga, the head teacher of Fort Portal Senior Secondary School, says his office has already received several cases of students seeking to be granted special permission to attend classes for only half day so they can also attend to their side businesses. Kateraga notes that drawing a balance between business and academics is not easy, so students need to be guided to focus on education as a priority. Kateraga, who heads a day and boarding school, also told the news that a number of his students have applied to leave the boarding section for the day section.
Drawing a balance between academics and business, it is not something that is easy. Actually, some of them have even been assisting their parents in shops. We have Asian students here who have been assisting their students. Actually, one of them went to India for a holiday. She has not yet come back. There's one in Chisenyi there who is assisting. They have a wholesale shop. But I think it goes back to us as teachers to guide these learners, to show them that the other one, it can collapse. But when you get your papers, this is the time that is going to determine the rest of your life. It's just a question of guiding them and counseling them, pulling them, not forcefully, but trying to show them the importance of concentrating for this remaining time. For example, someone is in a candidate class like senior six, it's only 1 year. You sacrifice, you make it, you go back to the business.
At Westville High School, Edson Tumwesje, the head teacher, says he has also received similar cases.
Students reporting with businesses to operate. We've not had some, apart from one girl when he was asking for vacancy, asked for permission continue operating her job so that she can do it alongside studying. And we shall sit and see how to arrange for such students so that in case of any other pandemic, these people do not lose their incomes.
There is time for everything under the sun. That entrepreneurship will be additional for you, but the time now is for the books. When you go back home, you can continue with the business.
Learners were also urged not to get upset when they are asked to cut off their hair, saying, for some schools, it is a policy.
For the girls with long hair, we as Westville, we had embraced it a long time, as if we had known that COVID will come. You see, we want to give education as all, so that even with long hair, the girl can learn how to keep smart and clean. So we allow girls, they come with long hair, they veil, they do the perfect so that even with the long hair, they can remain smart.
I only got a few cases of parents who are pleading, let my child veil, you know, she has long hair. But I was asking them, this one is not a married person, and this person is not a Muslim. You know, give that chance to Muslim students to veil. Here we respect all religious fraternities. Therefore, if a child comes and is a Muslim, he's supposed to veil. But Christians are not allowed to veil because some of them, they do it just for the sake of hiding hair, which is not okay with us.
Story by Rogers Sunday for the news in Fort Portal.